Hello friends, welcome back. So in this video we will learn projectile motion by analyzing the Bofors gun, which played a major role in India's victory in the Kargil War. So let's just first see the Bofors gun in action during the Kargil War before we proceed. So we just saw the Bofors gun in action during the Kargil War. So actually during Kargil War, Pakistani backed infiltrators had captured Indian posts, Indian bunkers located at peaks in and around the mountainous region of Kargil. So since the infiltrators had occupied the peaks, they were in an advantageous position, and from that position they could monitor the movement of Indian army soldiers, very accurately. So any advancement by the Indian army to capture those peaks, was foiled by the army, because the Indian army came under direct firing line from these infiltrators who were located at a height at those peaks. So initially during the war, Indian army suffered heavy casualties. So this prompted the Indian army to bring Bofors gun in action during the war. So these Bofors guns have a range of about 25 kilometers. So they can hit targets situated 25 kilometers away. So Bofors gun served two purposes basically during the Kargil War. Number one, they destroyed enemy posts without exposing the infantry. And secondly, they gave covering fire to the foot soldiers who then made advances to capture the peaks which were occupied by the infiltrators. These Bofors guns were very instrumental, especially in the battle for the capture of 0.4875 and Tiger Hill during the Kargil War. So let's consider a target denoted by this blue dot on a hill during the Kargil War, and let's say Bofors gun has been brought to completely obliterate this target. So let's say this target is situated at a horizontal distance of 10 km from the Bofors gun, and let's say the vertical distance of this target from the ground is 2 km. And let's say Bofors gun fires a shot at this target. So our objective is to find out the angle at which the barrel of the gun has to be fixed so that the shot fired by the gun hits the target accurately. So let the x and y direction be as shown in the figure. Let's say the barrel of the gun is initially fixed at an angle theta from the horizontal, and let's say this Bofors gun fires the shot. So if we draw the free body diagram of the shot at or the cartridge which is fired just at the time t is equal to 0, when the cartridge is just fired, then you will get the free body diagram something like this. So the only force which will act on the cartridge will be its weight, which will be given by mg. The cartridge or the shot will have an initial velocity, and the direction of velocity will also be at an angle of theta from the horizontal. Now the initial velocity of the cartridge or the shot for Bofors gun or any artillery gun is called muzzle velocity, and for Bofors gun, as per the specifications of Bofors gun, the muzzle velocity is roughly around 1000 meter per second. So from this free body diagram, what we can see is that the initial velocity is 1000 meter per second at an angle of theta from the horizontal. Now we can split the motion of this cartridge in horizontal and vertical direction, and we will do the analysis in horizontal and vertical direction separately. So let's first focus on the horizontal direction, which is the x direction. So we know the very famous equation of kinematics, s is equal to ut plus half at square, where s is the distance, u is the initial velocity, t is the time, and a is the acceleration, right? So in the horizontal direction, since there is no force which acts on the cartridge, the acceleration will be zero. So this equation will become s is equal to ut. So what is s in the horizontal direction? So this target is at a horizontal distance of 10 km from the Bofors gun. So if we convert everything in meters, so this 10 will become 10,000. What is the initial velocity in the horizontal direction? The initial velocity in the horizontal direction will be equal to u cos theta. So u is 1000 cos theta. So 1000 cos theta into t will be 10,000. So t will become 10 by cos theta, right? If we move to the vertical direction, then in the vertical direction, what is the acceleration? So the acceleration will be the acceleration due to gravity, which is minus 9.8 meter per second square. and this will of course act in the vertical downward direction, in the negative y direction. So, and in the vertical direction, what will be the value of S? S will be 2 kilometers. So this target is at a vertical distance of 2 kilometers from the ground. So I mean, this 2 kilometer will be 2000 meters. So if we apply this equation, this kinematic equation in the vertical direction, we will get 2000 will be equal to ut. So the initial velocity in the vertical direction will be what? It will be u sin theta, 1000 sin theta. So this kinematic equation of S will become 2000 is equal to 1000 sin theta t minus half into 9.8 into t square. Now if we put the value of t which we have obtained here in this equation, and if we do simple trigonometry, we will get this equation, tan square theta minus 20 tan theta plus 5.1 is equal to 0. So this is a quadratic equation. If we solve this equation, we will get two values of theta. Theta 1 is equal to 87 degree, theta 2 is equal to 14 degree. So this equation says that if we put the fix the barrel of the gun at an angle of theta 1 which is 87 degree, then also the shot will hit the target. And if we put the barrel of the gun at theta 2 is equal to 14 degree, then also the shot will hit the target. So which angle we should choose? So if we find out the corresponding time of hitting the target for these two theta values from this equation we will get t1 for theta 1 is equal to 87 degree as 191 second, and t2 will be 10 second. So of course t1, this we have to remove, this we have to ignore. So theta 1 of 87 degree we will ignore. So the barrel of the gun should be fixed at an angle of 14 degree from the horizontal. Well, one more thing which is important to consider here is that in this analysis we have ignored the effect of air, the surrounding air, on the motion of the projectile. However, in reality that will not be the case. I mean the direction of flow of air will have an impact on the motion of the projectile. However, for this example we have ignored the effect of surrounding air. So this typical path followed by the cartridge as it leaves the barrel and hits the target, so this path or this motion is called projectile motion. And whenever you get any problem on projectile motion, just split the motion of the object in x direction and y direction and apply this kinematic equation. In textbooks you will find lots of formulas for range and height and other stuff, which I would not recommend you to remember, because those formulas are derived from this approach only. So if you follow this approach, then you can solve any problem in projectile motion. So that's all I have in this video. Hope you have liked the video. Please do subscribe to my channel. Thank you. In the next video, I will come up with some other interesting topic. Thank you.